Welcome back to another video. This is Fini. Today we are continuing from our series of Visual Studio Code. So today let's look at how you can customize themes and color schemes in VS Code. Now, creating personalized environments is a great impact for you, especially for your productivity and comfort if you're developing or building something in Visual Studio Code. So it has a lot of customizations options for themes and colors. So first, what is a theme? Is an overall appearance of your editor. It includes the color, font styles, icon sets, everything, look and feel of your workspace. Then color schemes, on the other hand, is a subset of themes, specifically define the color combination used to highlight syntax or making code more readable. So now how do we access the color code? So let's go to settings, and in settings, just below here, you're gonna see themes. So when you see theme, you can click on color theme. And so here are some color themes that are already available. So you can use the up arrow to go up. You can see them. You can see the light theme. You can see the quiet light. You can see light default, modern light. And you just navigate through around to see something that you feel like you like. You see Monokai, all that. Red, night blue, that. So to change the theme, let's just click on the theme. And you can see my VS Code has just changed to this theme. Now, another way of finding theme is installing themes from the VS Code marketplace. So to do that, we shall click on the marketplace icon, extensions, and then we search for themes. So here you can see a number of themes, workbench themes, August themes, etc. So for example, let's click on this. And you can see how the looks and feels that are available here. So let's click on install. So when we install it, it has also different variations. So we can just scroll down to see, keep scrolling to see. And when I like that, I can press on it. So when I go to my files and open, this is how my piece of code is going to be looking in that theme. So let's go back to settings, themes. Color theme, let's keep scrolling to see. So we can search from what we just installed. And I think I like this. So I'm gonna press on that. So that will be our theme. You can see it has changed. All right, so how do you manage installed themes? Now, some themes may allow you to further customize them. So to do that, you basically go to settings again, themes, sorry, settings, and then here, so to change, we shall just search for workbench.color customizations, which is right here. So this is what we have. So when we go to the actual customization, you'll see that it has a JSON file here. So you can edit it in JSON file. Now let's try to edit this theme and see. So within the workbench color customization class, you see that it alters the background. If I choose the background red, or let's change it to, you see that this is just an example of customization. So if you don't need to customize this, it's totally fine. We can just put it back to default. We don't add anything here, and that is it. So thing you're adding goes into the workbench dot color customization, as you've seen in that example. And then using color picker, so for example, we had editor dot background. So we can just navigate here to color picker and then move around our cursor, you know. You see that? To change the color to what we want, we can do that. We can do that. So that is also using the color picker. Also, you can use live preview. So this was just to show you, but we don't need this for now. So let's just remove it. Now, another thing is using icons. So how do we install icons? So the same way we install extensions, we shall just go here to extensions, and then we search for icon themes instead and press enter. So we can close this, and here you can see there are a number of icon themes. So let's click on that and then click on install. So we can select file icon theme. Let's select that. So when you go to themes, file icon theme, you can see we can click on that And you can see that the icons for our project changes. That's the use of the icon theme. Or let's go back to settings, themes again, file icon theme. Let's change it to the Roblox that we just installed. And you can see that is how the files are gonna look like. You can just navigate through depending on what you really want. And minimal, you can see it looks like that. And I think I liked the setting. This looks really great. So that is working with file icons. So what are other ways of using VS Code? For example, accessing command palette, you just have to press Control Shift plus P, and the command palette will open for you. So you can search for whatever you want to search for. For example, theme. Let's go to color theme, and this is just how quick you can search for something that you want. So when you use the Control Shift P and search for theme, this will bring you to all the related commands about the theme or the colors that you want to work with when you go to the icon theme. So if I just quickly want to change our theme, I can just search for theme and then go to color theme, and I change to whatever I want. So you can do this for the different workspaces. So I can set this theme for this specific workspace, or I can create another workspace and give it a different theme. Basically, this is how you can customize the theme of your VS Code to light, to dark, to custom, to brown, to whatever you want. Thank you for watching. See you in the next video. And if you have any questions, feel free to ask in the comments.